So let me just say that the Ministry of Science and Technology deserves all of our commendation also for this visionary idea of a technology innovation expo. At home and abroad, Nigerians have always demonstrated remarkable ingenuity and inventiveness. And we know that with the right environment and policy support, there is no limit to how far Nigerians can go, especially with respect to innovation in science and technology. Equally worthy of note is the fact that Nigeria is a land hungry for innovation. Every challenge that we face in terms of security, infrastructure deficit, financial inclusion, and so on, is a natural laboratory for the manifestation of groundbreaking, homegrown innovation. As part of our own efforts to create a nurturing environment for technology and innovation in Nigeria, President Buhari has approved a new National Science, Technology, and Innovation Roadmap 2017 to 2030 for Nigeria. He has also approved the National Strategy for Competitiveness in Raw Materials and Product Development in Nigeria. It's our intention as a government to utilize this initiative to stimulate global competitiveness of our raw materials and support our ambitions for a diversified economy. In September 2016, the State House hosted the first Aso Villa Demo Day to showcase the innovation of emerging startups from around the country. Since then, the World Bank has supported a batch of those innovators with grants totaling about $3 million, the first tranche of which has already been disbursed. I'm pleased to note that the World Bank is committing an additional $3 million in funding for 6 technology hubs across Nigeria in our universities. The Aso Villa Demo Day, by the way, was a challenge for young people who were creating different types of startups, different types of technology innovation, and other types of innovation. And they were hosted at the villa. The president was there, and some may recall that Mark Zuckerberg, the founder of Facebook, was also there. In addition, the federal government plans to strengthen the technology and innovation ecosystem by supporting the development of new innovation hubs in partnership with the private sector. And this is well on course. We have recently concluded a competitive selection process for the private sector entities that will implement and manage the hubs. Each of these hubs will focus on solving the market challenges peculiar to the region of the country in which it is located. But perhaps more importantly, we are collaborating with the Bank of Industry, with the Civic Hub, which is a private hub, and other private sector entities to run a presidential technology innovation challenge in all Nigerian universities, public and private, and also some polytechnics in April of this year. Each university winner will be invited to an awards event hosted by Mr. President at the Villa. We are also setting up technology hubs in universities in the 6 geopolitical zones. And I think it's important also, as we do this, to celebrate the creativity and innovation of many of our young Nigerians who are doing incredible things in science and in technology, and especially in technology. Many are writing incredible software. Many are doing very creative applications in various aspects of enterprise. And we must commend the excellent work that they are doing. Again, I must say that we must celebrate also the innovation and creativity of the Nigerian military. The Nigerian Air Force has shown us what is possible where there is a drive to innovate. Only recently, the Nigerian Air Force launched its very advanced unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs. And these vehicles, they have shown as perhaps some of the most creative in the world. These are cutting-edge unmanned aerial vehicles, and they've just been recently launched, as we know. Before then, they had manufactured a revolutionary version of diaphragms that are used in fighter jets. They are now in the process of commercializing the product, and we're told that several different countries of the world have already expressed an interest in buying these diaphragms from the Nigeria Air Force. Military innovation is, of course, crucial. Indeed, the most transformational technologies the world has ever seen were actually military in origin. The internet is probably the best known, example of the ways by which military innovation, when taken seriously and commercialized, can actually transform technology, science and technology. Most recently, on February the 2nd, 2016, President Buhari signed a presidential executive order and this administration's fifth executive order for the planning and execution of projects and programs, especially in the area of science, engineering, and technology. Programs that have science, engineering, and technology components now have a special executive order. The Presidential Monitoring and Evaluation Council, under the chairmanship of the President, will ensure the faithful implementation of this executive order. The important thing about this executive order is that it says now that wherever there is local talent in science, technology, or innovation, we cannot get that talent from abroad. So if we are procuring any types of engineering services, technology services, or science services, so long as there's local talent, it is the local talent that must be patronized, and we must not import or pay for foreign talent. That's the content of that executive order. And I wish to urge all ministries and departments and agencies to align with it and to ensure that the lofty intentions of that order are met. Science and technology, of course, are key instruments for the realization of the objectives of our National Economic Recovery and Growth Plan 2017 to 2020. Our goal of moving Nigeria's economy away from a resource-based model to a knowledge-based model is one that we must take seriously, and the ERGP is a step in that direction. Innovation will create jobs, it will attract investment, it will boost exports, it will grow our economy. This is apart from the positive impact that it will have on our image and perception around the world. And of course, on our ability to project our soft power on the international stage. Ladies and gentlemen, we are confident that as a government, especially one that has science and technology as a major pillar of its development efforts, that we are prepared to build a much better future, and that we will continue also to encourage the Federal Ministry of Science and Technology to play the very important role that it's playing at the moment in advancing the frontiers of Nigerian technology. As contained in Executive Order 5, we will also establish centers for acquisition of technology in each of the six geopolitical zones of the country. We will provide intervention funds that will strengthen research and development through training programs and partnerships in Nigerian universities and polytechnics, technical schools and trade centers. Our goal is to develop a self-confident nation, one that is able to quickly identify and take advantage of emerging opportunities in a rapidly changing and rapidly evolving world. The private sector, of course, has an important role to play in nurturing innovation in Nigeria by directly investing in and by supporting our universities, our research institutions, and of course our polytechnics and other centers of learning. Commendation must go especially to the Nigerian Liquefied Natural Gas Limited, NLNG, as a prime example of a company that supports innovation through its annual Nigeria Prize for Science and Technology in collaboration with some of our universities. We must also commend Airtel and Sahara Energy for their support for the Aso Villa Demo Day and other creative endeavors that they have supported. Let me congratulate our young scientists who have emerged as the best in the 774 local government areas of the country. I commend your creativity and your competitive spirit. I'm pleased to announce that the candidates who emerged first, second, and third, respectively, in the final examination of the recently concluded Young Nigerian Scientist Presidential Competition, have all been granted full scholarships up to the PhD level in any science, in any science-related discipline of their choice in any of our universities. The future of Nigeria belongs to our young people. It is our duty as a government to create the enabling environment for them to not just to be nurtured, but also to grow to their fullest potential. Much of what needs to be done, especially in the areas of oil and solid minerals or land, are the resources that we have. But we know that the most important areas for us, the most important issues for us today, are in developing the knowledge, a knowledge-based economy. And it's that knowledge-based economy that will launch us into our next level as a nation, and to our next level even as a continent. And that human capital that is required is embodied in our youth. Tens of millions of incredibly talented men and women constantly pushing and striving towards greatness. And we will not let them down. We will harness their energy and their talents and make Nigeria stand out for its science and technology. I'm confident that working together in pursuit of a common purpose, we shall succeed. It is on this note, therefore, that I again commend the Ministry of Science and Technology and all of those who have collaborated in bringing about this very important Innovation and Technology Day. And I hereby declare the 2018 Technology and Innovation Expo formally opened. Thank you, and God bless you.